Welcome back to Undertale. I'm the RPG chick. Believe it or not, I managed to defeat or make the greater dog bored of me. I did pet him a few times and stuff, and then mostly ignored him, and he went away, and I got 40 gold, but no experience. So this is where we got defeated by that thing. So now at least we have full hit points. Well, actually, you can see it in the little box anyway, but... Continuing! I don't know which way to go. What's across that bridge? What if that hits me? Nothing happens. Squeak toys. It's a door. A door, a door, a door. Can't go through that door? Door. Does it have to do with some combination of these? Just trying a few combinations here. Oops. Not sure what I hit there. Alright, let's go back to the bridge then. Does this... That doesn't go anywhere. I can see the little house down there. It looks so cozy. Spider eyes. Alright, let's see what's over the bridge then. Ah, our friends.
Human! This is your final and most dangerous challenge. Behold, the gauntlet of deadly terror.
Wow.
When I say the word, it will fully activate. Cannons will fire. Spikes will swing. Blades will slice.
And Fluffy Dog will drop on me?
Each part will swing violently up and down. Only the tiniest chance of victory will remain. Are you ready? Because I am about to do it!
Well, what's the hold up?
Hold up? What hold up? I'm about to activate it now!
I can't move. Excuse me, guys. That, doesn't look very activated.
Well, this challenge, it seems maybe too easy to defeat the human with. Yeah, we can't use this one. I am a skeleton with standards. My puzzles are very fair, and my traps are expertly cooked.
Cooked?
But this method is too direct. No class at all. Away it goes.
Buy weapons of destruction.
Phew. What are you looking at? This was another decisive victory for Papyrus. Heh.
You ran off. Okay. What's up, Sans? I don't know what my brother's going to do now. If I were you, I would make sure I understand blue attacks. Right, you have to stand still. Find that out when fighting the, what do you call it? The master... What was it? Greater Dog. The Greater Dog, I believe it's called? Yeah. Blue attacks. The blue thing moves. We can't move. I thought he was going to tell me about blue attacks, but I think I figured it out. So what's up with that other place? With the, I guess we're going back there? Welcome to Snowdin. Get it? Snowdin. I can go through that. Okay. Welcome to Snowdin Town. Oh, they got shops. Ooh, save. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. And determination means saving. Use the box? See. How about no? Okay. Yes. Oh, I can put stuff in my inventory in there. Okay. Press X. Alright, so we're gonna go shopping in. Hello, traveler. How can I help you? Talk. Okay, we'll start off with some small talk, you know, and then go from there. Care to chat? Say hello. Hiya! Welcome to Snowdin. I can't remember the last time I saw a fresh face around here. I can't make out what voice I'm gonna give her. Where did you come from? The capital? Yeah, we're back to it. You don't look like a tourist. Are you here by yourself? Let's just repeat. Welcome to Snowdin. I can't remember the last time I saw a fresh face around here. Better. What to do here? You want to know what to do here in Snowdin? Grilby's has food, and the library has information. If you're tired, you can take a nap at the inn. It's right next door. My sister runs it. And if you're bored, you can sit outside and watch those wacky skeletons do their thing. There's two of them. Brothers, I think. They just showed up one day and asserted themselves. The town has gotten a lot more interesting since then. I'm sure it has. Town history. Think back to your history class. A long time ago, monsters lived in the ruins back there in the forest. Long story short, we all decided to leave the ruins and head for the end of the caverns. Along the way, some fuzzy folk decided they liked the cold and set up camp in Snowdin. Oh, and don't think about trying to explore the ruins. The door's been locked for ages. So unless you're a ghost or can burrow under the door, forget about it. Well, we came from the ruins, didn't we? Your life. Life is the same as usual. A little claustrophobic. But we all know deep down that freedom is coming, don't we? As long as we got that hope, we can grit our teeth and face the same struggles day after day. That's life, ain't it? Tough glove. Like tough love. Slap him, huh? Manly bandana. It has abs on it. Bicycle. Heals 11 hit points times 2. Eat it twice. Unfortunately, it takes out a... It takes a round to eat it once, I'm sure. Heals 22 hit points. It's my own... recipe. Well, we can buy all this stuff. Let's check the inn first before I buy anything. Bye now. Come again sometime. That's a cute song. It's a Z over it. Hello? Mime says that sleeping can recover your health above your maximum HP.
Really?
What's maximum HP? Welcome to Snowdin, Snowdin's premier hotel. One night is 80 gold. Well, feel free to come back anytime.
What if I just go up here anyway?
I can't.
If I go back here?
I can't.
If I check out the couch?
Nope.
Alright. Oh! Oh! Oh my, I'm all the- oh crap.
Alright, there's a lot to see here. Let me go back through, because I didn't mean to skip all this stuff. That's handy, though, that's there. Don't want to walk to the other side of town? Try the undersnow tunnels. They're efficiently laid out.
Well, now that I know what it is, I guess I should have read the sign first.
That lady over there. Something about her disturbs me. I think I figured it out. No, never mind.
Can I go in your home?
Isn't my little Cinnamon just the cutest? Bun buns are so adorable. Hee hee. Bun 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 bun.
Awful teens tormented a local monster by decorating its tree-like horns.
Yes, I think I ran into that. Sorta.
So we start giving that monster presents to make it feel better. Now it's a tradition to put presents underneath a decorated tree. This was a good thing those teens tormented that monster?
Like Winnie the Pooh. Can I open these presents?
It's a carefully decorated tree. Some of the presents are addressed from Santa to various locals.
Same.
Yo! You're a kid too, right? I can tell, because you're wearing a striped shirt. I wonder if that weird skeleton is an adult or a kid.
I love this place.
This town doesn't have a mayor. But if there's ever a problem, a skeleton will tell a fish lady about it.
Okay.
That's politics. 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 And, politics. What's this?
Can't look at that.
Oh, doggos we have here. Oh my god, what's that huge thing with the teethies?
Are you drunk?
No matter where I go, it's the same menu, the same people. Help. I want no drinks and hot guys. I guess the bartender's kind of a hot.
Hope you guys like my voices.
You better watch where you sit down in here, kid. Because that big guy will jump into your lap and give you lots of love and attention.
Okay, okay.
We're sentries, but we never get any respect. I wish those skeletons would throw us a bone. We love bones.
Okay. Can I drink this drink?
Nope. I'm thinking to get a spiked collar to show up my personality. It makes a statement like, attach a leash to me and take me for a walk, please.
Oh, there's the greater dog. Greater doggo? Something.
What? that supposed to be like burping or something? It's playing poker against itself. It appears to be losing. I guess it's playing for dog food or kibbles or something. What is this, a fish? Or a duck? I put out a line for some girls today. Someone told me that there are plenty of fish in the sea. Well, I'm taking that seriously. I'm literally going to make out with a fish. I guess I could ask out Undyne. I think she likes someone already.
Those dogs are part of the Royal Guard, the elite military group led by Undyne. She's rude, loud, and beats up everyone who gets in her way. It's no wonder all the kids want to be like her when they grow up. I want to be like Undyne when I grow up too!
Alright, what the hell is this thing?
Isn't human food different from monster food? It does things like spoil. And when you eat it, it passes all the way through your whole body. Disgusting. I'd love to try it sometime. And I've heard they have things called bathrooms.
The capital's getting pretty crowded, so I heard they're going to start moving here. I don't want to see the erasure of our local culture. But I definitely want to see some city slickers slip into their butts.
What?
Yeah, bring them on.
The jukebox is broken. So what the hell's playing? Alright, let's talk to this guy. He's on fire. Maybe he knows a wizard from Planescape Torment.
He doesn't speak, sir.
Grilbs said that he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch the stuff. I wonder why that is. I had no idea what voice to give him. So I'm guessing I can't pass through, go to this door or anything. It's just like talking to people.
Right. Everyone is always laughing and cracking jokes, trying to forget our modern crises. Dreariness, crowding, lack of sunlight. I would join them, but I'm just not very funny. At least I'm not making puns. Puns?
We all know the underground has problems, but we smile anyway. Why? We can't do anything, so why be morose about it? Smile, smile.
Library.
Let's go in the library. Oh my god, there's so much stuff here. I love this place.
Welcome to the library.
Yes, we know. The sign is misspelled.
That look in your eye. You're someone that has trouble doing crosswords, aren't you?
I love working on a newspaper. There's so little to report that we just fill it with comics and games. When I was younger, my teachers gave me word searches when they ran out of assignments. I thought they were a waste of time. But look at me now. I'm the number one word search creator in the entire underground.
Yeah. Can you look at some of these books? It's a school report about monster funerals. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. When monsters get old and kick the bucket, they turn into dust. At funerals, we take that dust and spread it on that person's favorite thing. Then their essence will live on in that thing. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kind of sick of writing this. While monsters are mostly made of magic, human beings are mostly made of water. Humans, with their physical forms, are far stronger than us. But they will never know the joy of expressing themselves through magic. They'll never get a bullet pattern birthday card. What? Here I am, writing this book. A person comes in and picks up the book. They start reading it. Oh, sorry. I'm still writing that one. That's funny. Because they are made of magic, monsters' bodies are attuned to their soul. If a monster doesn't want to fight, its defenses will weaken. And the crueler the intentions of our enemies, the more their attacks will hurt us. Therefore, if a being with a powerful soul, struck with the desire to kill... let's end the chapter here. Monster History Part 4. Fearing the humans no longer, we moved out of our old city, home. We braved harsh cold, damp swampland, and searing heat, until we reached what we now call our capital. New home. Again, our king is really bad at names. Love, hope, compassion. This is what people say monstrous souls are made of. But the absolute nature of soul is unknown. After all, humans have proven their souls don't need these things to exist. Great. That's what humans are known for. I can't look at that. I can't look at stuff. Can I go through this door? No. Can I look through this window? No. Okay, we're done. Hi, Barbie. What the heck is this thing? It's a mailbox overflowing with unread junk mail. Okay. And this one's empty. I guess this contains or would contain real mail. This mailbox is labeled Papyrus. Look inside. You realize that would probably be illegal. I'm looking inside. It's empty. It's locked. The Papyrus's home? Andor Sands? It's locked from the inside. Oh, look at the big giant ice thing. What's on the... Now, I want to see what's up north. Just past the library. Or the library. More stuff. Oh, what's this? Let's play Monsters and Humans. Said that. Ah, to be young again. The world sure felt boundless. Does this one talk? You aren't gonna make me be the human again, are you? Ah, what a beautiful knock. Maybe if I don't answer, I'll hear it again. Ah, my patience rewards me. Oh, they're manufacturing... That's where he throws it into the water. They're manufacturing ice cubes. Well, I can't even do anything there. And this... I guess I can't go past that, no. Okay. That sounds spooky. Ring, ring, who's this? Hello, can I speak to... Wait a second. Is this the wrong number? Oh, it's the wrong number. The wrong number song. We're very, very sorry that we got it wrong. I don't know how the song goes, guys. Oh, it's the wrong number. The wrong number song. We're very, very sorry that we got it wrong. Click. It's spooky here. The wrong number song. I still miss Toriel. Oh. Okay. I say... That's pretty cool, though. Five attack. Oh, I'm definitely getting this bandana for sure. It has seen some wear. It has abs drawn on it. Armor defense 7. Oh, I have the tough glove already. Are they selling that in there? So that's our stats now. We have the tough glove already. I don't see any indication that we can use two tough gloves, although that would kind of make sense, but yeah, I'm just gonna leave it. Wait. We should sell our old thing then. This doesn't look like a pawn shop. I don't know how it works where you come from, but I know I'm not using the voice. If I start spending money on old branches and used bandages, I've been out of business in a jiffy. So we can't sell anything? If you're really hurting for cash, then maybe you could do some crowdfunding. I hear people will pay for anything nowadays. Damn, we can't even sell anything. So let's buy the... Carrying too much. I mean, eventually I will use this box. The toy knife. Let's just... We can't sell it, so I'm gonna... You know what, just in case, actually. Rather than just drop the thing... Now, let me just remind myself what this stuff is. Butterscotch pie. Gives you all your hit points back. The knife scream, which I have 3 of, heals 15 hit points.
faded ribbon. If you're cuter, monsters won't hit you as hard. Put the faded ribbon in there. Another bicycle and another cinnamon bun. Done. Now we're full. We can't even pick anything up until we use some of this stuff. Which could be kind of limiting, but we'll see how it works out. Sell. And go back to the end of town. Off into the great unknown. So that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.